We're now joined on the line by the incoming AFP Chief of Staff, Lieutenant General Felimon Santos Jr. General, good afternoon.
Good afternoon, Paul. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon, and congratulations on the new post. But we do want to ask you, what would the AFP be like under your leadership, and what reforms are you going to push?
During my assumption, the AFP will continue to do its mission. Actually, the AFP, its campaign plan, will continue the campaign.
What campaign is that, sir?
That's a campaign against the lawless element, mm-hmm. against insurgents, against the terrorists.
Sir, you're going to retire August 2020. That's less than a year. Would you have enough time to push for those reforms and maybe improve on that campaign?
Actually, there's no problem with serving 6 months because it's a continuing effort for the military. We have, as I told you, we have a campaign plan to na sinusunod natin. Then, yan yung parang pinaka-biblia natin. So, anybody who sits there will continue the campaign to accomplish our end state, our mission. Mm-hmm. That is bringing peace and prosperity to our country. Mm-hmm.
General, the President Duterte is again open to peace negotiations with the communist rebels. Now, you were at the forefront of going up against them when you headed the Army's 7th Infantry Division. And I do believe that you were part of also peace and security programs of the government. So you've worn two hats, sat on both sides. But what are your views on how to solve the insurgency in the South? Is it through peace talks or the insurgency's eradication?
Actually, with the desire of the president to end the armed conflict with the insurgents, he decided to initially open again the peace talks, mm-hmm. the national peace talks. But on the ground, he has also issued the EO-70 that is forming the national task force in ending local armed conflict, local communist armed conflict. That
yes.
is... where everybody is on board, the local chief executive, our regional government agencies, the military, and the PNP doing their part in that, what we call the total approach for the whole of nation approach.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Wherein the military focus on clearing areas of armed threats, just like in communist affected areas, the military first clear the area of armed threats so that the local chief executive could deliver the basic services needed by our people, and the local, the government agencies in the area support all this program.
Right, and it's if I'm not mistaken, it's not just clearing areas of armed threats, but there is some sort of localized peace talks in those regions, right, sir? Are you have you witnessed possibly full effectiveness of localized peace talks as opposed to a national level?
Yeah, I'm a witness here at the Eastern Mindanao Command. Well, in fact, only this year of 2019, we have so many surrenderies. We have surrendered firearms in totality for the whole year. We accounted for almost 1,200 firearms surrendered and through combat operation.
Mm-hmm.
I'm a witness of it in some areas, just like Davao Oriental, which is Davao de Oro now, which is the Compostela Valley before, is the hotbed of NPA before. Including here in Davao City, in the Pakibato District. But now you would see that within the last semester of 2019, we have a very limited armed engagement with the NPAs. It indicates that that they have lesser capability now, and some others move to farther areas, to non-populated areas, which we are now trying to also clear.